And here is the Writer's Almanac for Saturday. It's the 1st of August, 2020. It's the birthday of the alchemist and spirit medium Edward Kelly in Worcester, England, 1555. Worked as an apothecary's assistant, studied at Oxford, and in his late 20s, he approached a very learned man named John Dee, who was a close consultant to Queen Elizabeth I, and Mr. Kelly offered his services as a seer. Kelly said that he was able to contact angels, that he had visions in his crystal ball. The angels delivered messages, strange characters written in tables, messages that scrolled from the angels' mouths like ribbons of paper. And the two of them transcribed volumes of this angelic language, and Kelly developed a red powder that he said would transform base metal into gold. The two of them traveled all over Europe, Poland and Prague, and then Kelly said that his angels were ordering the two of them to share everything they had, including their wives, and that was the end of their partnership. Kelly was imprisoned by Emperor Rudolf in a tower near Prague when his red powder failed to produce gold. It's the birthday of the first female astronomer, Maria Mitchell, 1818, the island of Nantucket, Massachusetts, daughter of Quaker parents who believed that girls should have the same access to education. Her father was an amateur astronomer, and the girl learned the mathematics of astronomy when she was very young. By the age of 12, she was assisting her father with his astronomical observations. Then she opened and ran her own school for girls, training them in the sciences and math. And October 1st, 1848, she focused her father's telescope on a distant star and suddenly realized she was looking not at a star but at a comet, and she recorded its coordinates, and the comet became known as Miss Mitchell's comet. In 1865, she was the first woman appointed to the faculty of the newly formed Vassar College for Women. It's the birthday of Herman Melville, 1819, New York City, born to a family of Revolutionary War heroes and merchants who had fallen on hard times. He left school to become a bank clerk, then he tried farming, teaching. He took to sea at the age of 18 as a cabin boy on a merchant ship bound for Liverpool. Came back, tried his fortune in the West. He saw the prairies, he saw the Mississippi headwaters, the Falls of St. Anthony, returned to the East. 1841, he signed up for the whaling ship, the Acushnet, to look for whales in the Pacific. It was an adventure. He jumped ship in the Marquesas. He was held by a band of Polynesians. He escaped from them, jumped that ship, made his way to Hawaii, and then back to the mainland. He was 25 years old, and he wrote about his adventures in Polynesia and about whaling in his first novel, Typee, which was an instant bestseller. Then he wrote another one, O Mu. And then, under the influence of the Transcendentalists and Nathaniel Hawthorne, he wrote his masterpiece, Moby Dick, which got mixed reviews, which disappointed his fans who were looking for another adventure story. And Herman Melville settled into life in New York City as a customs inspector. Here's a poem for today by Darnell Arnault entitled Psychology Today. Have you ever had delusions of grandeur? I read all about it in a magazine on the coffee table at Dr. Broadwell's office. Have you ever thought you were meant for something special, but you were afraid, afraid if you tried, you'd fail. People would think you a fool. You might risk everything only for delusions of grandeur. I have thought that, I mean. Psychology Today by Darnell Arnault from What Travels With Us. That's the Writer's Almanac for Saturday, the 1st of August. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.